Let's actually just start with basic data and facts. Where is Boston Dynamics today in its production of robots? Where does it take place and what does the supply chain look like?
Thanks for having me, Ed. So Boston Dynamics is building three products right now, and two of them are in the market. Spot was our initial product, and we have about 2,000 of those robots out with customers. We've launched a second product, Stretch, which is a warehousing robot, and that's having success with big players like DHL. And our third product will be humanoids. We are manufacturing all of these in the United States and plan to deploy them internationally as well as in the United States.
Robert, I always like to go to our audience on social media and say, the following CEO is coming on the show. What would you ask them? And based on what you just said, the first customer was, if you are approaching a new customer, how would you go about a new task? What does the teaching process for the specific form factor of robot look like? And how long does it take to go from sort of inception to deployment in that industrial use case?
That's a great question.
Thank you. I didn't think of it. It was someone else's. Go ahead.
AI has definitely changed the game here, and it's accelerated the rate at which you can teach robots new tasks. But much of the AI that you need to make humanoids successful is still to be built. What we found practically is that when you introduce a new robot like Spot, which we introduced in 2020, it took us until about 2023 before we really were starting to nail the applications that customers wanted and that generated value for them. And so it's not an overnight activity. It's really learning about the customer problem and building a solution, not just a prototype robot.
Let's talk about whether the solution of Optimus over at Tesla, is that a competitive threat for you right now, Robert? How realistic do you think the timeframes are on that from Elon?
Well, you know, Elon, I think, exaggerates often. He's got a history of doing that, but he's also, proven the ability to invent the future. So we take Tesla and Optimus very seriously. They also share an advantage that Boston Dynamics has, which is we're attached to a major automotive manufacturer, and that creates a unique opportunity for us, but also for Tesla to not only build at scale, but deploy at scale and basically have consume your own robots.
I mean, you've got a collaboration with Hyundai, for example. You've also got partnerships longstanding with NVIDIA and others. Just how resilient do those partnerships and do those end customers seem at this economic moment, Robert?
Well, I think the partnership with Hyundai is going to be really amazing because they can be both our manufacturer and largest consumer. We can, if we need to adjust manufacturing of automotives to make robots more successful there, we can do so. And that will really be key to achieving success. So I think the whole world is seeing the opportunity for this new generation of robots to expand significantly. And so I think there's just a lot of promise in this industry right now.